as we step into 2025, the once promising skies of the 3D printing industry seem overshadowed. Investments have slowed, fewer startups are emerging, and many publicly traded companies struggle to make a profit. Our industry continues to grow, but only a handful of companies are seeing positive revenues. It's as if the pioneers of this technology are becoming victims of their own success. Perhaps aspirations in the 3D printing space have been set too high, and it's time for a more balanced perspective. While 3D printing has the potential to make a significant impact, it won't drive industrial transformation on its own. Like a movie needing both lead and supporting actors, manufacturing relies on the interplay between traditional technologies and 3D printing. Traditional methods will continue to lead, while 3D printing plays a vital supporting role, enhancing efficiency and flexibility. A good example of this interplay between traditional manufacturing and 3D printing is the metal hinges for foldable phones printed in China. Millions of units that demonstrate how 3D printing can meet the demands of high volume production. These 3D printing metal hinges play a supporting role in a complex device, which is largely manufactured using traditional methods. But their innovative design makes all the difference and highlights how 3D printing complements conventional manufacturing. It's about strategic integration into broader industrial processes and a shift in focus from innovation to practical applications. 3D printing stands at the crossroads between innovation and practical application. The technology has proven its unique value, but the next step involves moving from technology innovations to widespread industrial use, creating exciting new opportunities across industries. This will require two things. The first one is what I call power to the people. As experts in 3D printing, we need to recognize that while we know the technology, our customers are the experts in their own fields, whether that's aerospace, eyewear, medical, or consumer products. We have a lot to learn from them. Each industry and company has its own unique manufacturing needs. Some prioritize efficiency, others focus on quality, cost, or speed. So our role is to keep excelling at what we do best and give power back to those who understand their challenges best, the users. This power to the people approach could mean opening our software to enable custom workflows, or offering greater control over hardware settings to meet specific production demands. Secondly, we need to remove some of the remaining barriers. In order to achieve profitability and growth, manufacturers need to scale up their applications to volume production and make their 3D printing processes cost-effective. This journey to scalability and cost efficiency represents a challenge. Managing increased complexity, maintaining quality standards, and controlling costs. Additionally, many still lack the knowledge and expertise to integrate 3D printing into their production processes. This is where collaboration within the 3D printing community becomes crucial. Rather than competing for small wins, our industry must unite to define standards, simplify adoption processes, and remove complexity, and make 3D printing cost-effective and accessible. A good example is Leading Minds, a new consortium of leading 3D printing companies to address the most pressing challenges that manufacturers face in adopting and scaling 3D printing technology for industrial use. In conclusion, the 3D printing industry is at a critical juncture, transitioning from a focus on technological innovation to delivering real business value. If we want to accelerate industrial adoption, we need to give more power to the users, and our industry must come together to help manufacturers adopt and scale 3D printing for industrial use. These efforts will drive the journey towards a new industrial reality.